All right. You've been honest with me, and I'll be perfectly honest with you back. I don't like you, Zander. You are constantly involved in criminal activities. You associate with dangerous people, including Sonny Corinthos. But worst of all, you have repeatedly put Emily's life in danger.
Dad, you're just...
You need to hear me out. I love my daughter, and I don't want to lose her. Now, obviously, Emily has found something worthwhile in you because she has stuck around for such a long time. Now, I don't approve of what my father did to the both of you. It was cruel and unjust. The worst thing that anybody in a family can do is interfere with two people who love each other. It causes serious damage. I know what that's like because my father caused me to lose something very precious years ago. I don't want history to repeat itself.
Are you saying what I think you are?
I'm still not happy about this, Emily. And I will worry you as much as ever, but I will not stand in your way. And I'm not going to allow anybody in this family to do it either.
You're the best.
Just wait. You haven't heard our conditions yet. You will be allowed to see Zander, but only with our permission.
No problem.
I'm glad to hear it.
Is that it?
One more thing. Non-negotiable. You have to move home until you go away to college.
Is that okay with you?
Oh, Emily, it'll be wonderful to have you come home. I've missed you so much.
I've missed you too. Look, can we have a minute alone so I can say goodnight?
No.
Okay.
So, did you lock Emily up? You know, I'm going to have the gardener cut down that blasted tree first thing in the morning, and I think we'll just seal that window over.
Hmm? None of this is needed, Father. We've handled the situation.
How? Have you grounded Emily for the rest of the school year? I was thinking that if we sent one of those exchange programs for the summer, maybe to Spain or even China, that would be good.
Sorry, Grandfather, but my parents have actually decided to trust me.
With restrictions.
Which I agree to.
Why is that deviant holding her hand?
Because we're allowing them to date.
Oh, have you lost your mind? Don't you realize the depths that he could drag her down into? She will become an accomplice to his criminal behavior. She'll become a moll, shot at by gangsters.
You have no say in this, Father.
We have made our decision.
And first and foremost on our list of restrictions is you keep your mouth shut. If you don't, I will allow AJ and Ned to send you off to jail for your various crimes and misdemeanors against Zander.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Are you clear on that?
I am the patriarch of this family, and nobody values my opinions.
Grandfather, I'd like to say goodnight to my boyfriend. Would you like me to give him a kiss right here in front of you or at the front door?
This is absolutely preposterous. Giving Emily permission to kiss that deviant right before our very eyes.
What's that I hear? The sound of a jail cell.
Oh, come on, Sean.
They're watching every move we make.
I don't care. All I can see is you. Do you realize how long it's taken for us to get to this point?
Yeah, I do.
Hey, everyone. It's just a kiss. It's not like the eighth grade wonder of the world.
Can we just give him a little privacy here?
Oh, come on, the entire family watching. It kind of creates a nice intimate moment.
All be quiet, you two. Look.
Come on, stay. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean it.
You're so amazing.
So are you. Good night.
See you tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, it feels good to say that.
Mm-hmm.